as I welcome in my partner, Alex Jones. Alex, a big night for the Black Bears to take on the Columbus River Dragons here on a Saturday night as we turn the calendar in the final month of the regular season.
Yeah, Brooks, this feels, the atmosphere is playoff hockey. It feels like that level of excitement, of electricity. Even during warm-ups, you saw the guys looking more intense, more focused. Everything is shrunk down. The ice is going to shrink. Everything becomes an inch-by-inch battle at this point. And this is going to be a great preview for what we can expect from the Black Bears in the playoffs.
Well, let's go ahead and take a look at Black Bears Rewind presented by the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club. Talk about what happened last night. A lot of things went right for the Black Bears, even though Elmira got on the board first with a power play goal to open up the scoring about 5 minutes into the contest. People like Chad Lopez and Tyson Kirkby getting back on the score sheet. Kirkby with two, Lopez with one. But the main story was one of the new guys, Connor Smith, the first star of the night last night, getting two goals and one assist.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. Connor Smith in his debut looked incredible. I mean, Brendan Stanko in his debut also looked incredible. I was speaking to him last night during the jersey auction, and we were both just saying how it felt like he almost had two out there. And it was a great night for the rookies. I mean, even Andrew Logar was on the ice and playing some meaningful minutes there at the end. But the true star of the night is Connor Smith. Outside of Tyson Kirkby's 100th career point coming on a goal, he had the best game out on the ice for any of the Black Bears. Took a bad penalty early, but that's the difference, sort of feeling out the difference between professional play and college play. College play has those gaps where you can kind of get away with those mistakes. At the professional level, you cannot get away with those mistakes. It is not possible for you to be able to do that.
All right, and also worth noting, Black Bears finished with a season-high 73 shots on goal. Elmira held to just 22, so Binghamton tripling up Elmira in the shots department. We're going to take a timeout, come back with the Tully's Coach's Corner after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back into the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. Triple Cities Family Dental makes your smile their priority. You can schedule an appointment today by visiting them online at triplecitiesfamilydental.com. And now time for the Tully's Coach's Corner. I was able to catch up with Coach Sherwood earlier today right after they got off with an optional morning skate. Most of the scratches from last night were on the ice, as well as tonight's backup goaltender, Riley McVeigh. And Jeremy Forget was out there as well with a couple of the forwards and a few defensemen. And coming right off the ice, I was able to catch Coach Sherwood in his office. So we'll go ahead and listen to our pregame interview with interim head coach, Grant Sherwood.
Now time for our Tully's Coach's Corner. Once again, I'm joined by interim head coach, Grant Sherwood. And Coach Sherwood, a 6-2 victory last night, and it looks like the offense got back on the swing of things against the Elmira Mammoth on Friday night.
Yeah, I mean, even with the shot total, we almost came close to breaking the record, but great cycle. It's great owning the puck down low and then getting it low to high, D-walking the line, getting in that front presence, all that good stuff that I've been preaching for the past, like, 3-4 months. Looked like it came all together, and, yeah, I was very happy with them. I thought we could have scored a little bit more. I know that's being, like, a little selfish, but that Proud Luck kid played pretty well in that.
Yeah, he had 67 saves and a losing effort, definitely his highest of the season. The Black Bears had only 5 defensemen last night, and do you think that even though at one point you were down to 4 with Coachman sitting in the penalty box for his fighting major, that the 4 guys who were out there did a good job rotating?
Oh, they did an awesome job, and having Fitzgerald back in the lineup was huge. You can just tell by the way he skates, how he takes ice when it's when there's the open space, how he gains zones, all that good stuff, and even the way he breaks out pucks, and then obviously we got the big man Schultz holding it down back there. Matt, too, I thought he had a much better offensive game, making plays, not fumbling the puck as much, and then Ollie just looked like right where he belonged.
And also, the new guys from Adrian College did a great job. They combined for 4 points. Connor Smith was the first star of the game with 2 goals and an assist. And it's got to be a little good for you, also for the team in general, that having those new guys come in straight from the collegiate game, transitioning to professional, essentially without missing a beat through game 1.
Yeah, my first thing I noticed was just their intensity. They're very hungry for pucks. They were hunting pucks, whatever you want to call it. They wanted the puck on their stick, and they didn't want to give it up, and they cycled it very well. I'd like to label Stanko as like a buzzsaw. Like, he just works his butt off and annoys defenders and gets in front of the goalie's face, makes plays. He's very sticky on the puck. Where Connor Smith, he is just a complete sniper. He owns the puck. He's hard to knock it off. His big presence is so huge, and hopefully it makes defenders shy away like it did last night.
Yeah, I talked with Connor a little bit earlier today, and he said that people tend to not pick on him, and I'm starting to see why. standing out there at 6'4", over 200 pounds, you're not going to have too many guys in this league pick on Connor Smith. All right, so as we get forward tonight against the Columbus River Dragons, a season split. So far, both games go to overtime down in Columbus, and the rubber match between the two sides here today. What kind of momentum can this team get should the Black Bears come away with a victory tonight?
This is huge. I mean, I'm looking forward is just consistency, and last night, yeah, they played great, but like, are they just gonna hang their hat on that? It's gonna be a flash in the pan, whatever you want to call it. They need to show up tonight, and this game's a lot more important. I don't like to say one game's more important than the other, but this is top team in the league, and we got to be ready to go, and we got to put last night in the rearview mirror and show up.
All right, Coach, anything else the fans should look out for tonight?
Just a great hockey game. I think there's going to be a little bit back and forth. Both teams have good power play units. Both teams have good PK units. It's going to be a battle, good goaltending. I think it's just going to be a really good hockey game, to be honest.
All right, Coach. Well, we hope it sure is on our side as well. Thank you for your time. We appreciate it, and good luck tonight.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Brooks. We appreciate it.
That's the voice of interim head coach Brandon Sherwood. More coming up after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
How's it going?
How are you?
I got from Ithaca to here in about 45 minutes.
Welcome back in for another edition of the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. Before we get to tonight's injuries and scratches, let's go ahead and inform you on 2 games going on the out-of-town scoreboard. First, The Motor City Rockers are up on the Port Huron Prowlers in the battle up in Michigan. They started at 6 o'clock. And last refresh on the website, the Rockers currently hold a 1-0 advantage over, ooh, check that, they just scored. It's a 2-0 lead over the Prowlers. So Rockers over the Prowlers right now as it stands. Now Carolina up 2-0 over Mississippi. That game getting ready to start the second period as well. And in Elmira, not too far down the road, Danbury up 1-0 against the Mammoth in New York. One game starts later tonight. That's Delaware against Watertown at 7:30. And that's our first look at the out-of-town scoreboard. We will update you that at the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Now we turn to tonight's injuries and scratches brought to you by the Court Jester Athletic Club, Binghamton's premier fitness athletic facility. And Alex, the scratches tonight, Josh Newberg, a healthy extra, JT Walters, still out with the newborn. Update hopefully on that next week. I did not get an update from Coach Sherwood today from the locker room, but hopefully we'll have good news to pass along soon. Kyle Powell out for personal reasons, as is Austin Thompson. Gino D'Angelo is an extra in the healthy department, and on loan still over in the SP is Jamie Boussel. So those are tonight's injuries and scratches brought to you by the Court Jester Athletic Club. And now we turn to the starting lineups for the Columbus River Dragons. Cody Rogers and Tristan Petrie on defense. Josh Petrantonio, Kyle Moore, and Jacob Kelly on the forwards, with Christian Pavlas in the net for the River Dragons. And on the opposite side, it's going to be Colin Fitzgerald and Jake Schultz on the blue line to start things off. And the same starters as last night on the forward group, Connor Smith, Brendan Stanko, and Jesse Anderson on your so-called top line tonight. And in goal, back-to-back nights for the second time this season, it's Taylor Joseph.
Yeah, and Taylor Joseph looked hot last night. Brooks did an excellent job in net. Going to be really interested to see how these young guys do on this first line. Smith, Stanko, and Anderson really seem to be gelling at the end of that game, and I'm excited to see what they can do against one of the class teams in the league.
Just to point out some notes on this forward group for Columbus, starting Jacob Kelly, 69 points on the year, 37 goals and 32 assists on his sides. Kyle Moore, one of the newer additions to the squad, only played in 11 games, 1 goal and 4 assists. And the last forward on that group, Josh Petrantonio, he's got 15 by 22. We're going to take our final timeout. Thank you for listening in to the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. When we come back, we'll have the anthems followed by the BAE Systems opening faceoff. Back with you after this on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. For another edition of Black Bears Hockey, Kander Elementary just got done singing God Bless America with their big group out on the ice. And now we turn over to Shenango Valley Middle School for the presentation of the national anthem.
Thank you.
Excellent job by Shenango Valley High School performing their rendition of the national anthem, and also Cander Elementary doing a wonderful job on the God Bless America beforehand. Now we're getting ready for another ceremonial. A puck drop. Alex, it's first responders night. The Black Bears wearing custom jerseys for the second night in a row, this time with the black base, a badge on the front, insignified by the Black Bears logo. They got red, white, and blue, and the three crests of the EMS, fire, and police first responders.
And an excellent night, something you're always proud to have on your jersey when you're representing people who make such a difference in our community.
Yeah, and also a post-game jersey auction going on as well. So if you're listening around the concourse, or maybe you're at the concession line right now, go ahead and sign up across from the merchandise stand. You can sign up to bid on the jerseys post-game as they try to roll up the carpet for the ice crew here. I believe they're using all the carpet for those two big groups, and they don't have the carpet out there for the ceremonial puck drop. But it's a great opportunity, and if you can't get a jersey tonight, you have the opportunity to purchase a first responder Black Bears t-shirt.
Which are going fast, Brooks. I've heard we're very close to running out of those as well.
Yeah, they are a hot commodity, and remember that the arena has already been going all day long. We had the Hart Cup game going on earlier today. Binghamton Fire, winners for the second year in a row, defeating the police department 8-5 by the final score. 36 shots on goal for the police, 35 for the firemen, and the firemen get the last laugh as they will hold the bragging rights until next year. But a really great game between two great teams, and that's a game where at the end of it, everybody's a hero. And even though they were facing off with each other, they're on the same team as soon as the game is over.
100%, Brooks.
All right, now it's time for the BAE Systems opening faceoff. It'll be Jesse Anderson matched up against Josh Petrantonio. And it looks like we are officially ready to go here. And the rubber match is officially underway as Columbus wins the opening faceoff. They pull it back into their own zone. And the first period brought to you by Dragon Billiards Instruction. If you want to learn pool, you need to visit them online at dragonbilliards.com or visit them in person over in Vestal. Anderson coming in trying to split the defense, tried to center up a little bit too late. A couple of guys wearing some makeshift numbers as the first shot on goal is put on by Fitzgerald. You're going to get a look at Brendan Stanko. He's wearing number 3 tonight. Connor Smith is going to wear 20. And Andrew Logar will wear 2. Justin Samero will wear 5. So all the college rookies will be wearing non-traditional numbers that they are on the roster as. Connor Smith coming in trying to use that big frame. He's going to run into LaBelle, who has just as big frame, if not bigger, for the Columbus blue line. Now coming back across, Storjahan throws it on goal for Columbus's first shot, and Joseph will swallow up at the top of his crease and hold for the first pause in the action.
And Brooks, that first offensive possession for the Black Bears was an excellent one. They got a couple offensive chances, a shot from the point, Colin Fitzgerald, an excellent start so far for the young guys and the returning Anderson.
Both teams with their first line change. Storjahan had the faceoff won, but it's going to be pushed out by Don Oliveri wearing 13 in black tonight. Gavin Yates coming down the left wing side, tried to sidestep a defender, but instead puck is going to be pushed back out into the neutral zone. Falls onto the stick of Tyson Kirkby, and they pull back into their own side, and we're going to try a breakout again. Onto the tape of Gavin Yates pushing down the right side of the ice. He's going to drop it back for Boylar. Boylar looking for a tip. He got one off the backside of Kirkby, but it was wide of the target. Now Oliveri tries to throw one out in front. Going to be knocked away by LaBelle. Don't know that he reacted the right way to that puck. Kirkby and Jurich play catch. One chance opportunity for Jurich. Turned away by Pavlos. Back up to the blue line. Oliveri trying for a slap pass down low with Kirkby. Too hot to handle as it rolls off of his stick. Storjahan. Lost it over to Oliveri. Kirkby tied up in the corner, takes a little bit of a shove. He's going one on two down low. Gavin Yates will come in to even up the numbers. Back up to the point for Oliveri. His wrist shot looking for a tip. Kick out in front. Kirkby hacks and whacks at it inside the blue paint, but Pavlos will swallow up, and the linesman going to have to come in and separate the two teams early in this one.
and a little bit of rough stuff in front of the crease, Brooks.
Yeah, Jemayev got a hold of Tyson Kirkby. Almost had him in a partial headlock as Kirkby was the one hacking and whacking at it, trying a stuff opportunity. And we saw last night, thanks to our great job on the camera crew, where the goaltender Proudluck for Elmira thought he had the puck covered, but it was still available. You could see it on the replay, and you got players from both sides poking at it, one team trying to push it out, and one team trying to push it behind the goal line. Faceoff pushed back by Lopez for Schultz. A shot put on, and Pavlos will steer it up high into the air. Just outside the faceoff dot, Tommy Aldworth, the former Black Bear, tried to reverse it around the boards and now finds the stick of Petrie. It's a turnover, though, as Lopez gets over to it, tries to center up. His pass is going to be blocked back up to the blue line. Coachman will just throw it to an open ice area, and now Columbus will skate it out of their own zone. But Coachman reads the play at the red line and throws it right back in. And so far, Binghamton doing a good job here on the forecheck, making things very hard for this River Dragon club. Schultz will paw it down at the red line again. No quarter given by the Black Bears as they come right back into the offensive side. Lopez's backhander a little bit high and wide of the target. And this will ride off the glass and out of play. It'll be an offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Black Bears.
And what you need to see here from the Black Bears going forward is a little more pressure. They've done a good job getting the puck in and forcing on Columbus when they are on the forecheck. But you'd like to see a little more offensive possession like we saw with the Don Oliveri, Jurich, Tyson Kirkby, Yates group. That was an excellent job by them. As we see a little bit of set play here coming probably from Smith, Anderson, and Stanko.
Yeah, Fitzgerald pinching in from the blue line. He's at the top of the faceoff dot. And Petrantonio is going to be asked to leave. Jesse Anderson will stay put. Anderson wins it back cleanly to Fitzgerald. Oliveri's wrister is blocked at the blue line and out of play. Right away, Jacob Kelly doing a good job getting out and marking Oliveri right off the rip.
Oliveri is one of the most dangerous shooters in this league, maybe even for several leagues up. He is a guy, if you can get the puck on his stick, it's going to be a problem for the Columbus River Dragons.
All right, next pause we're going to have, we're talking about the Thompson & Johnson Equipment Company goaltending matchup. Another faceoff win by Anderson. Fitzgerald will just wrap it behind down low. Smith self-pass off the boards. Can't catch up to it, though, as Cody Rogers will be the first man there. Nice pass right onto the tape of Jacob Kelly. He's peppered from behind by Stanko, and now the puck ends up behind the net. Moore just outside the trapezoid lost it, and Oliveri strips it away, and instead he's going to skate back out into the neutral zone. Fitzgerald, though, takes a little bit of a miscue from the Black Bears into the offensive side, skating on in, over to Anderson, skate to stick, rolls off at the last second. No shot comes of it for the Black Bears. Held in, though, by Stanko. Puck will knuckle into the corner. It is Connor Smith, two goals and assists last night, will come in, chase after it, holds the puck in. Linesman says Black Bears are still on sides. I think they believe they were going to have to be tagging up. Stanko, though, will turn it over, and Petrantonio will skate away. He's on his forehand coming in. Shot, blocker save made by Joseph. Comes right back out into the zone, or neutral zone, I should say. Line change now for Columbus as Boylar is met with pressure on the forecheck. Now Tyler Jurich will just play the puck behind his own net off the glass. Now Columbus's turn, just get on the forecheck. That puck's going to be thrown up high into the air, and it goes off the scoreboard here inside the arena for just the second time this year. Let's get to that Thompson & Johnson Equipment Company goaltending matchup. For Columbus, it's Christian Pavlos, 6-1-2 on the year, 299 goals against average, and a save percentage at .897. Taylor Joseph for Binghamton, 6-2-2. Same exact goals against average at 2.99 and a save percentage at .914. So almost very comparable stats between these two goaltenders. Puck is put behind the net. Boylar giving pressure on the forecheck, forcing LaBelle to think twice about what he was going to do. He will carry over and pass it up for Lane King. King gets the blue line and no further and will go cross corner on the dump in for Storjahan. Jemayev was in the top five of scoring last year in the FPHL. Plays it over. Gets it all the way back up to the point for Greco as his shot was looking for a tip on target. Stays off. Greco, a shot is in the legs of Joseph, but instead going to be cleaned up by the Black Bears. Throw it down the length of the ice, and they're going to call that icing. Binghamton thought that went off the pad of the goaltender.
I also thought, Brooks, the defender at center ice made an attempt to play that.
Yeah, well, we'll see if they get together and talk about it. What we do know is we have our first media timeout of the night. Still searching for the game's first goal. Back with you after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
We are up to 719 seniors at home this season. Thank you, Vision Federal Credit Union, for your support of us in American Special Hockey Association.
Good first five.
On the ice, we have the Worldwide Support Sports Supply Ice Crew. Tonight, we're doing things a little differently, everybody, so take a look up on the video boards for the Fresh Pepper Lucky Seat. Hey, you! Yeah, you! You are our Lucky Seat winner tonight. We'll be over with two tickets for the next Black Bears game next Friday at 7 for Hall of Fame night against the Delaware Thunder. Congrats!
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. And Alex, for the first 5 minutes, Binghamton's been the aggressor here so far as they've had the more sustained offensive zone time.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. Two shots on goal for Columbus, four for the Black Bears. However, the possession has been, if you're doing percentages, it would have been very much in the Black Bears' hands.
Cody Wickline and Tyson Kirkby are going to tango in the faceoff dot for this one. So the icing will stand. Binghamton was not allowed to change while we were away at our media timeout. Shot put wide of the target. A heavy hit laid on by Yates on the follow through. Wickline over to the loose puck. It'll hop over his stick and fall over to Tyler Jurch, who was able to push it out into the neutral zone. All five staying on the ice for Binghamton. Looks like everybody's still fresh after that media timeout. This hops over the stick of Wickline, down low outside the trapezoid. And we continue to play on here as Tyler Jurich will circle back in his own side. Coachman cross ice, tape to tape for Tyson Kirkby. Over the stick of Yates, might have hopped over the last second. This one's going to be icing this time against Columbus as that pass can't connect with anybody dressed in white.
Yeah, and a longer shift for Columbus. They're not able to get a full change. So there's going to be some tired bodies. See if the Black Bears can take advantage of it. Getting the line of Lopez, Samero, and Lagar out there.
Yeah, Black Bears going with 11 forwards and 5 defensemen for the second night in a row. Coach Sherwood talked about in the Tully's Coaches Corner how big it was to have Colin Fitzgerald back in the lineup. Played a lot of ice time last night, or had a lot of time on ice, I should say. As Columbus will win this faceoff, throw it back out into the neutral zone, and right on cue, Fitzgerald gets over to a loose puck and chops it right back into the Columbus zone as Vanelli will chase after it from behind. 26 dressed in white, plays it over, and it's a turnover. Now coming in is a shot's put on by Logar. Pavlov swallows up immediately. And we're have another scruffle behind the Columbus net. Nothing's going to come of that one. Let's get to tonight's officials, brought to you by the Atlas James Construction Company. Kyler Spies and Joe Testa, the two referees, Joe Palenko and Cameron Campbell on the lines. And Cameron Campbell, the only member of the four-man team tonight who saw the Black Bears on Friday. So three out of the four new here tonight.
Seem like they've really let the flow play go so far. There haven't been any chances for arms to go up, but they really seem to have let the guys play.
Binghamton staying with all five on the ice. Schultz can't seal the blue line and the wall, but Lopez will block a pass up at the Binghamton zone as Petrantonio tried to enter on a spinorama kind of move. Schultz plays it over, one touch, and now the lefty comes in. Tried to backhand it over for Lopez, just poked wide of the target. That was played off the glass down for Samero, and he will just backhand it back into his own side, let the Black Bears come back in from the red line. Schultz wraps it around the boards. Pavlos could not get a stick on it. Sealed up is Mac Lewis, and it will find the stick of Petrantonio now as he tries to dance through the Binghamton forecheck. Right back up for Lopez. Doesn't have anybody at the line to receive that pass as the Black Bears were in the midst of a partial line change.
It's fine there, Brooks, because you get that guy on the ice. It's a smart play to force Columbus to reset, start their breakout play, especially how good the Black Bears have been so far on the forecheck.
Lopez double shifting right now as Parker and Lewis come on to be the wingers, and look out. Petrie blows a tire, couldn't get the puck out of the zone, and leads to a Binghamton takeaway. Schultz tries to play it over to Lopez instead. Hit laid on by Lewis. He lost a stick on the way through. Here comes Fitzgerald. Saucering over for Brett Parker. Forehand, backhand denied by Pavlis. Best save of the game so far belongs to Christian Pavlis. Now Columbus coming the other way, trying to touch up. Storjahan shot blockered away by Joseph. His best so far early action. Storjahan down low. Plays it across for King. King tries to center up, read beautifully by Connor Smith, and Smith will skate away one on two. Smith dancing around one man as the old school hip check failed on the way through. Binghamton with the puck, a one-timer wide of the target as Michael Greco collects himself from off the ice, trying to hip check Connor Smith. Finds it down low to the former Adrian College Bulldog, held in by Oliveri. Slap pass looking for a tip, finds its way into the corner. Now Boylar, his shot blocked. Oliveri pinches in, does a good job blocking a clearing attempt through the blue paint and out. Boylar now still with the puck, leaving it over for Smith. Wrist shot, swallowed up by Pavlos, and this one's coming out all the way for Greco, who's gonna leak out behind the Binghamton net. That puck was hit pretty hard by Boylar, I believe. It looks like we're gonna have a penalty coming up once the referee decides to blow the play dead.
That's gonna be a hit from behind on Boylar, Brooks. He saw the numbers that which should be the stop sign. Could be maybe a boarding as well or a charging, but it's going to be one of those, probably a minor. Didn't come in super hard. He came in, but he saw the stop sign. Should have thrown it up there, which is essentially what the Columbus player was looking for there is, hey, I'm going to just ice this puck in the corner. Hopefully somebody hits me from behind and we can hop on the power play.
That's a good heads-up play. It looks like Greco's going to be okay. Remember, he was the one who went for that hip check on Connor Smith just a few minutes ago. Now he's going to skate off on his own power over to the bench, and the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill is going to make its way out there onto the ice. Time of the penalty, 8:32. It goes against Mathieu Boylar.
And that's the easiest one in the world to call, Brooks. I mean, numbers showing, coming in with some speed. He did throw on the brakes a little bit, but you can't hit a guy from behind like that if you're Mathieu.
So Columbus is operating at 19.5% this year, 35 power play goals. They've given up 5 shorthanded tallies. And we got, it looks like it's going to be a neutral zone faceoff.
Because of the scrap after. Krupp very not happy right now, Brooks, with that decision.
Yeah, and I was talking with Tom Callahan, the voice of the Columbus River Dragons, before today's contest, and the power play has been pretty good for Columbus so far, and he said that they really don't have 5-man units. They just keep it normal as they have, as this is going to be offsides at the line. One thing that I did notice from our trip down to Georgia earlier this year with Columbus's power play, they seem to be their own worst enemy. At least in the 2 games that we were there, Alex, Columbus getting a lot of offsides as they just did right there for the first time, but they also put the puck out of the offensive side themselves on missing passes or throwing them to empty spots. We'll see if that continues to be a trend as the Black Bears will kill off the first 20 seconds as that faceoff is going to be pushed back, slapped down by Coachman. And now Columbus couldn't hold it at the blue line. Kirkby spun around a little bit with the free hand, but not enough to wave a call. Coachman now will saucer that one all the way down, and once again Pavlos will set it up on a tee for Columbus behind the net. Logar and Samero, two of the new college rookies on the forecheck for the Black Bears, and Logar doing a good job of eating up some precious time right now. Samero pulls it back into the zone, and the Black Bears are going to play keep away right now against the River Dragons. Fitzgerald plays it back, and Oliveri's waiting for it. And here slapped that one down all the way, and Pavlis had to make the save. That should register as a shot on goal, as that would have gone into the net. Stretch pass, this is going to be icing against Columbus. And so far, through the first minute 13 on this power play, nothing going for the River Dragons.
And something, Brooks, I saw previously about 3-4 minutes ago on a Schultz-Lopez 2-on-1 in the defensive zone. Peter Antonio, a great guy for the captain for the Columbus River Dragons, got a stick lift on Lopez that prevented a goal. Otherwise, that would have been most likely a goal in the back of the net for the Black Bears.
All right, 40 seconds left to go on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill for the Black Bears. Oliveri will slap a pass off the boards to himself. Tried to play it backwards. Got it right back, shorthanded. Oliveri doing a lot of the heavy lifting and plays it right back to a wide open Colin Fitzgerald. This has got to be very frustrating for Coach Bouchard's club right now. No shots on goal through the first minute 40 of the power play, and Binghamton's been the team with more of the possession. Now Kelly starts the engine all the way across. A self pass for Jamea off of the board. King can't corral it, and it's going to be thrown down the length of the ice. No shots on goal for the River Dragons.
And we're back at full strength, Brooks.
On their first power play of the game. That's a textbook penalty kill for the Black Bears. Now let's see if they can generate some offense with some a little momentum generated by that great penalty kill.
And an excellent hip check there by Colin Fitzgerald. Prevented his man from getting in the zone, separated him from the puck.
Tyson Kirkby at the red line will dump it in, throws it on target. Pavlis will have to steer it in front for Petrie. Back out into the neutral zone. Here comes Jay Krupp, left wing side. Through traffic, his shot will be blocked by his own man out in front. Rogers at the top of the umbrella had his shot blocked by Yates partially, but Joseph still had to make the save. Rogers fanned on a shot this time, and now Gavin Yates plays it over for Tyler Jurich at the blue line. Jurich, though, had it stolen away by Petrie and reversed behind the net, and Columbus will go the other way.
An excellent defensive play by Petrie.
Now, Columbus has been in Binghamton all week long practicing here inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena. They vacated the premises yesterday to go to Watertown, where they won 4-1 against the Wolves, got out to a 3-0 lead going into the third period. Coasted a little bit in the third period. That's when Watertown got their one goal and they were threatening for more, but they were able to withstand the pressure from the Wolves and hang on to win in regulation again. They have not clinched the Continental. Carolina can still catch statistically, but more on that coming up in just a little bit. Still searching for the game's first goal in this one. River Dragons 0, Binghamton 0 as well. You're listening to Fox Sports 1430.
Thanks, guys. Make sure you call Arc Repair for all of your plumbing, heating, cooling, and water treatment needs. All right, Binghamton fans, it's time for the Avery Auto Service season ticket holder of the game. We're heading over to Section 3 this evening. Our winner tonight is John Christian. Congratulations, John. You just won yourself a free house oil change courtesy of our friends at Avery Auto Service.
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. We've got a good one on hand. The shots on goal so far, 8 for Binghamton, 4 for Columbus. It's a neutral zone faceoff with 8 minutes left to go. And Columbus 0-1 on the power play, did not register a tally. We're back to 5-on-5. Anderson, Stanko, and Smith on the forward groups. Oliveri, Amboy, Lahr on the blue line, and Oliveri's done a good job handling the puck so far, especially on that last penalty kill, Alex.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. Oliveri is one of the better stick handlers we've seen so far this year, and him being able to handle in a phone booth allows you to do a lot of the things on the penalty kill.
It's what Coach Sherwood calls risk-reward with Oliveri handling it, especially on the defensive blue line. Storjahan through traffic tries to put a shot on goal, follows it up off the side of the net. Now Stanko with it. Makes a nice move over Lane King, and Connor Smith is going to be the first man to the puck. It was tipped on the way through. Fergo tried to clear it back out. Stanko is going to intercept. Smith and Stanko play catch with each other, trying to center up for Anderson, but it rolls off the tape of the Black Bears at the last second. Played into open ice, and now going the other way. Nobody picked up Jamea. His slap shot is going to be absorbed by Joseph. That time, Black Bears get caught a little bit out of position defensively, but Taylor Joseph stands tall at the top of his crease to make a save.
The irony that you just mentioned, the risk-reward of having somebody as offensively minded as Don Oliver, he gets caught a little out of position trying to pinch into the offensive zone, and leads to a very good, probably the best chance so far from the Columbus River Dragons.
For Trantonio Lopez, fight for this loose puck, going to be won back with help thanks to Jake Schultz over to the open man on the wing, Brett Parker. Went off his skate, though. Bounced back over into the slot. Petrantonio plays it over. And a shot off the mask of Taylor Joseph. He shakes to make sure everything's still good to stay on. Hit put on Kyle Moore and a diving effort by Fitzgerald to throw it back out into neutral ice. A lot of hustle in that kid from Chicago. Now Parker, self-pass, nifty move. Shot on and a save made by Pavlis. That was a little bit of a changeup. Took a little bit longer to get to the target as Fitzgerald's wrister is blocked on the way through. Brett Parker with a grade A scoring opportunity here in period number one.
I also think Paulus thought there was going to be a pass there from Parker rather than the shot started to cheat over a little bit.
Fitzgerald peppered on the forecheck by Kelly. Now Mac Lewis plays it over to the faceoff circle where Lopez had it roll off of his stick. He goes off on a line change. Shot blocked at the blue line. Aldworth coming on in. Centering out in front. Joseph made the save back up to the blue line. Rogers fans on it. It works it down low. Joseph out of his net and crease. Plays it back over. Blockered high by the Black Bears goaltender. He's seeing some shots now. Best sequence of the game for Columbus so far. Down low. Wickline trying to go to the back door for Day. But instead, blockered right back to Wickline's stick. Boylar pinching in against the boards. Lewis pushed down from behind. Plays it over for Gavin Yates, and Yates is going to start his engine. Yates throws on the brakes, waits for some open opportunity. His pass fanned on. Kirkby turnaround shot off the chest of the goaltender and melted down.
Tell you what, Brooks, I was surprised there wasn't a penalty in the defensive zone for the Black Bears. Mac Lewis hits the ice, and the Columbus player finishes with a knee right towards the head. Normally, that's something that the refs will pick up on.
5:27 left to go here. Columbus changing some of their players. Binghamton going to keep all five out there on the ice. Face off one back. Can Yates hold it in? Temporarily he does, but it's going to be intercepted by Jemayev. And now over for Petrantonio. Jemayev has a puck go end over end into the corner. And we're going to have a whistle from the official. Don't know what that one was. Clearly staying in play.
Thought that the puck went out of play, Brooks. He gave him my bad on that one. I think he thought it was going into the net rather than just a slight pop-up.
First responder night, specialty jerseys for the Black Bears. First responder t-shirts also available for purchase out on the concourse. Tonight is a great night because it's benefiting the American Heart Association. Last night benefited Sock Out Cancer. So a lot of good causes, getting some recognition and some funds this week thanks to the Black Bears. Now Vanelli will chase after a loose puck on his own end as Kirkby could not corral the faceoff win. Storjahan now tries to deke around Oliveri, centering it up for King as King's wrist shot poked wide. This time it goes off the glass, stays in play as we continue on. Schultz off the board, his pass is stolen, but Columbus puts it back out into the neutral zone as one of their defensemen was not holding the line. That was for go. Now Jemayev coming in, saucers up, looking for a tip from Storjahan out in front. Didn't connect with anybody. Oliveri puts it right back over for Gavin Yates. And this is going to be a high sticking infraction as Columbus touches up, and the Black Bears, when we come back from this timeout, are going to be headed to a Henny Hard Seltzer power play, Alex.
Yeah, that's Janeff getting Yates right in the grill.
We'll see if we have a Heinz Energy replay depicting that high sticking infraction when we come back. The Black Bears on a Henny Hard Seltzer power play with 4:27 left to go in the first period. Back with you after these messages on Fox Sports 1430.
if you or someone you know should be recognized as a hero of the game, visit NickumsandBlackBears.com.
Power outages are a thing of the past when you have a Generac home standby generator installed by the team at American Electric. Give them a call today or visit them on the web at AEG.
Black Bears are headed to a Henny Hard Seltzer Power Play. Be bold. Choose flavor, choose Henny Hard Seltzer. Binghamton, the top power play in the FPHL, operating at 26%. They have 62 power play goals this season. Face-off is going to be pushed back by Connor Smith, and Anderson with Smith will play catch with each other. Cross ice over into the bumper for Lopez. That play didn't look good from the start, as it's going to be pushed down the length of the ice for Taylor Joseph. And Schultz, the lone defenseman, out there with four forwards. And now Lopez trying to play it over to Connor Smith, has his pass blocked, but Anderson will pick it right up coming down the left wing side. Anderson circles behind the net, tries to play it back over for Schultz, read beautifully by Columbus. Back up to the point for Smith. Smith looking over for Schultz. Just outside the faceoff dot, across for Anderson, sending up out in front. Pavas made the save, rebound, they score. Chad Lopez, the Pez from the Southwest with a power play goal, and Binghamton's on the board first.
And an excellent series there for the Black Bears. They show why they're the top power play in this league. Just tape to tape to tape to tape. And a lucky bounce in the back of the net. I think that should have been Stanko's first goal of his career books, but just an incredible save by Columbus's goalkeeper prevents it from going in the back of the net. However, fortune favors the bold. Lopez right in front of the net puts it in the back of the net for the Black Bears' first goal of Hart Cup First Responders Night.
Matt Damon, big Black Bears fan. I see what you did there. Faceoff is going to be pulled back into Columbus zone. As you get a final look at the Heinz Energy replay, right place, right time for Chad Lopez. And the Black Bears up 1-0. Columbus crossing the line off sides once again, as Aldworth was just a hair early into the zone with 3:33 left to go.
As we watch the Henny Howard, or the Heinz Energy replay, Brooks, Stanko, if he gets a little elevation on that puck, I think it's in the back of the net. Puts it low, easy rebound for Chad Lopez, however, as the goalie sways all the way across trying to save the puck.
Lopez family in attendance this weekend to see their son. Got to talk to Mr. Lopez last night. He was enthralled with the Sock Out Cancer jerseys and think he might be trying to go 2 for 2 in jersey auctions this season. Now Wickline crossing back in. This time they're on sides. Low angle shot put on the short side all the way back up to the point. Krupp misplayed it. Luckily his defenseman was there to hold it in. Wickline going one-on-one with Coachman. Now for Aldworth. Aldworth steering on his backhand, pulls all the way back at the blue line behind the net of the Black Bear goaltender. Coachman could not play it. Centering up, back up for Rogers in the slot. Blockered away by Joseph, stays in. No, they're going to say that got into the safety netting.
I would agree with that, Brooks.
Okay, so either my eyes are deceiving me or we just have a lot of pucks either staying in or going out.
I think it hit right where the net meets the glass, just right above it, which caused it to drop like that directly off.
With that last goal, Alex, Chad Lopez now extends his point streak to 6 games. He has 8 assists in the last 7 games, and until last night, he was held goalless since February 25th. Storjahan's shot blocked by Fitzgerald, down on a knee, cleared out into the neutral zone, and now Tyler Jurch is going to start his engine, trying to leave it back for Yates. Shot blocked, still available just outside the crease. Columbus gets over to the loose puck, and Jemayev puts it back out into the neutral zone. Fitzgerald is all over the ice tonight.
Showing off his hops there, Brooks. He was getting up.
Yeah, always dangerous jumping up and leaving the blades of your skate up in the air, landing right back down. But hey, he's a pro and he's done it. He's going to be tipped on the way through, nullifying icing. Fitzgerald will reverse it back over, but Storjahan's waiting for it. His centering a pass is stolen away by Oliveri. Oliveri coming in, leaving it over for Kirkby. Kirkby into the corner. Takes a bump down to the ice, gets right back up. Yates on the forecheck trying to keep the puck in the offensive side. It scurries out of the zone. Binghamton will be forced to touch up. Yates starting and stopping, comes back. Jurich, a slap shot wide. Schultz trying to hold the line. Anderson does. And Yates with one hand doing a good job, stick handling around the Columbus defense, down low over for Jurich. Schultz gets a little bit of a puck luck in, and now Yates tries to center up for Jurich out in front. Couldn't get it to go. Chad Lopez gets his 13th of the season, and now Kyle Moore coming in on a breakaway, trying to tie the game up, but Joseph made the save. Columbus leaking a forward out of the zone, got behind the Black Bears defense, and Joseph was at the right place to make the save. 1 minute left to go here in period number one, as Schultz's pass is deflected off of the glass onto the tape of Connor Smith. Stanko, college teammate with Smith, in the corner, gonna fight for it. Anderson pokes it up high. 3-on-3 battle. Anderson up to the line for Coachman. Shot wide of the target. Rebound cleaned up by Columbus at the blue line. Gonna be poked into the Columbus bench and out of play with 40 seconds left to go here in the opening period.
And a little return to center from the Columbus bench right into the hand of the linesman. As we look up at the Heinz Energy replay, Yates and Jurich getting denied on the doorstep with an excellent, excellent scoring opportunity. Yates being one of the best facilitators on the Binghamton Black Bears team.
Yeah, and Tyler Jurich still searching for the final two goals to surpass Ahmed Mahfouz as the all-time FPHL goal leader. He held off the score sheet last night and had a little bit of frustration as he had a great chance in the final minutes of the game to get at least one. Now down low, Wickline, one touch passing out in front. Joseph with another kick save. Puck back out to the blue line. Taylor Joseph's been on his A game here in period number one. It's a turnover though. Look out, Stanko coming in, couldn't get a handle on it in the final 10 seconds of the period. Greco playing it over. LaBelle will play it off of the glass back out into the neutral zone. And that is where we will go to the locker room after the first period. Black Bears up 1-0 over the league-leading Columbus River Dragons.
Yeah, Brooks, and I think Taylor Joseph on that last stop breakaway opportunity got real lucky. Got a post helping him out.
All right, we're going to take a timeout. Come back. We'll have a very special interview coming up with Connor Smith after his performance last night with two goals and an assist. We'll have a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlight, and also a look at the Columbia Mutual Life stat sheet. Go ahead, Alex.
And we were just getting a look in the Heinz Energy replay. Columbus was complaining that they thought it was a goal, and the Heinz Energy replay shows pretty definitively that stays out.
All right, Excite Motorsports intermission report coming up after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Your Binghamton Black Bears are headed back to the Commissioner's Cup playoffs for the 2023 season. Playoff tickets are on sale now. You can purchase them on the third floor of the Vision Veterans Memorial Arena by calling 607-722-7367 or visiting Ticketmaster.com. The Binghamton Black Bears, in conjunction with the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame, are proud to announce three inductees into the 2023 Hall of Fame. Come early to the Black Bears game on Friday, April 7th, to see Josh Hennessy, Patrice Robitaille, and the late Charlie Jaworski officially be inducted into the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Bricks Barber Company Clip of the Week.
Time. Getting the puck out of their zone. Takeaway for Josh Newberg. Severo scores! Cashing in his first goal at home as a Black Bear, second as a professional hockey player.
Bricks Barber Company, located in the number 5 Commons at 41 South Washington Street, right here in downtown Binghamton. Give them a visit today.
If you're looking to install a beautiful, durable, and handcrafted countertop, call Alice James Construction. The Southern Tier's most trusted stone fabrication will design and install your dream countertop and let you choose from a premium selection of natural stones like marble, granite, or quartzite. Stone or granite countertops starting as low as $35 per square foot installed. Schedule your free quote and receive a free sink with your countertop project. Call 607-275-5495.
Think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
And passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We'll pass you a beer.
Good day.
Share a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2 and 3 bedroom units, fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Magic 101.7.
Best radio station.
Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever!
Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol, cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired. And it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
Into the slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
We'll be right back.
Danbury, Elmira, 2 apiece. Mississippi, Carolina tied at 3. And Motor City up by 3, 4-1 over the Prowlers. When we come back, we'll have the second period brought to you by Lofts at JC. So don't go anywhere, folks. More Black Bears hockey is coming around the corner after these messages on Fox Sports 1430. Welcome back to the second period brought to you by our friends over at Lofts at JC. The Lofts at JC are the official housing partners of the Binghamton Black Bears. They have beautiful 1, 2, and 3 bedroom units on the complex, and they would love for you to schedule a tour and fill out an application online. You can do so at any time at loftsatjc.com. Second period, Black Bears up 1-0 against the Columbus River Dragons. Both games went to overtime down in Georgia, and we have 40 minutes left to go at least in this one. And now we are ready to go. Second period underway. Teams have switched sides, and Columbus with temporarily control of the puck. Anderson tried to pass it over to Schultz, but instead comes all the way back to Taylor Joseph, who plays it off the wall and going to be intercepted by Moore on the way through. Now Colin Fitzgerald, we've said his name a ton tonight, comes across the line, had it poked away off of his stick. Now the River Dragons try to give it right back to the Black Bears as Schultz puts it onto the tape down low for Stanko. Rolls off of his, a wrap chance, denied from Stanko. And Fitzgerald looking for a tip, wristed wide of the target. I believe Petrie either got a body part or a stick to it. Thrown down the ice. This is not going to make the line.
Skate Brooks, I believe he kicked at it, and I think it hit the skate on the way through.
All right, Black Bears cross the line. They're onside. Connor Smith, the shot, and Pavlis made the save. Fitzgerald pinching in from the blue line, holds it in, but Anderson cannot get over to the loose puck. Held in, though, by Yates at the blue line. Throws a little bit of a head fake, like a juke, like he was a running back right there. Does get it behind the goaltender's net. That allows Binghamton to complete their line change and get that scoring unit of Jurich, Yates, and Kirkby out there on the ice. Good poke at the blue line offensively by Yates and Jurich, forcing Jemayev to come back into his own side. 90 seconds gone, and now Storjahan crossing over for Columbus. A wrist shot is turned out by Joseph. Rebound was a little loosey-goosey, but it pops back out to the Black Bears sticks. Gavin Yates crossing over. Low angle off the mask of Pavlis. Still in the corner now, Tyson Kirkby with the puck, trying to restart the cycle for Jurich down low. Finds Yates. Yates turning around, gets into the low slot, blocker save made by Pavlis. Pavlis doing a good job keeping this a one-goal game. Jemayev, though, blew a tire. Black Bears have a 3-on-2 the other way. Oliveri over for Cookby. Took his eye off of it. Down low for Oliveri. Rap chance. Or excuse me, stuff chance, I should say. Pavlis with a rap check. That's what I meant to say. Out in front. Stretch pass off the tape of Jemayev. Can Yates get back? He does. Columbus will change their players. Yates staying on. He's been out there for over a minute now. Gavin Yates, toe drag. Pavlis made the save. Rebound, it's in. Mac Lewis, 10th goal of the season. They stayed with the play, and the Black Bears up by a pair.
And an excellent veteran move by Tyler Jurich. This is part of the hockey game you don't really get to see unless you're here in the arena paying attention. Jurich knows his legs are tired, quickly hops off, gets Mac Lewis on the ice, jumps in the rush with Gavin Yates. Yates throws the puck on net, and Mac Lewis is just able to strong arm it into the back of the net for the Black Bears' second goal of the game.
Take a look at the Heinz Energy replay. Yates with the drag. Pavlis made the initial save. Lewis was denied his first shot and then scored on the second opportunity. Here's Ben Sperudi on the goal call. Mac Lewis, his 10th of the season. Black Bears gonna look for some more. So just one assist on that goal. It's Mac Lewis from Gavin Yates. And now Lewis trying to return the favor over to Brett Parker. Down low for Lopez. Coachman holds the line, D to D with Schultz. No shot could be put on there by Schultz. They just get it down low outside the trapezoid. Right in front of the Zamboni door. Pavlis will backhand it right back into the corner. And now for go, wide open. Can skate out a little bit and throw a pass. Schultz backhands one out of the zone, and now Parker gets it around Vanelli. Lopez can't dangle around one man, but Schultz picks up the loose change. Schultz a wrist shot and blockered all the way into the netting. Off the pad, Pavlis.
Yeah, that's quite a bit of heat coming off Schultz there. He got a head of steam and really, really screamed that one at the kick pad of the Columbus keeper.
16:33 left to go here in the period. The Anderson line now out there. Anderson trying to win this one on his forehand, the way that he's positioned for this faceoff. It's going up against Petrantonio. Shot put wide by Stenko, still searching for his first professional goal. He's got two assists in two games so far. One-on-one now as Cody Moore comes in. Stuff chance denied by Joseph. Second opportunity turned away by the keeper. Puck jumps out and onto the stick of Brendan Stako. The Black Bears go the other way. Saucer over to Smith, trying to get it through, but Petrantonio was covering up defensively. Good two-way center right there, play by Josh Petrantonio, and that's a veteran play by the captain of Columbus right there.
Yeah, an excellent job getting back into the defensive zone and defending a very good offensive chance for the Black Bears.
Fitzgerald has lost his stick. He's going to chase after it temporarily. Joseph makes a save, cleaned out by the Black Bears defense. Fitzgerald picks up the lumber as Columbus touches up from behind their own net, just stayed in front of the icing line. And we continue to play on here with 15:35 left to go. Anderson applying pressure. Rogers gives it up. And now Storjahan turns it over to Gavin Yates. Yates cross ice. Over for Tyler Jurich. They are on sides. Jurich slap pass over to Kirkby, trying to outweigh the goaltender, but he ran out of real estate. Kirkby behind the net, starting and stopping, trying to center up for Jurich, trying to tie the record, but it will roll off of his skate onto the blade of Storjahan. And after the red line, Storjahan just dumps it in. Joseph coming out of his net to play it. It'll ride the top of the boards back out, and it's tipped in out in front, and Columbus is on the board.
And unfortunately, Taylor Joseph not able to get that puck out of the offensive zone. Lands right on the stick of the defender for Columbus, throws it at the net, and I think he got a tip in front, headed into the back of the net.
River Dragons are on the board at 4:56 of the second period. And I want to see if that was tipped out in front by a Black Bear.
I don't think so. I think it was tipped by the Columbus forward. It's a good job getting a puck on net. And I think, what number is that, Brooks? I didn't really get a chance to see that on the
I think
the
it was Lane King.
Columbus River Dragons, goal scored by third number 39.
Yep, it was Lane King. And Greco gets the assist. 4:56 is the time of the goal. Columbus on the board. See how the Black Bears respond. Schultz looking for a tip out in front from Jurich. Rebound off the side of the net. Jurich in the offensive side, proving to be a problem. Fitzgerald throws one to the target, tipped in. Is it Tyson Kirkby in front, or is it Tyler Jurich on the back door?
Pretty sure that was Tyson Kirkby, Brooks. He had his stick at an odd angle, almost flipping it. Rather than having forehand, went with a backhand tip with the curve directly pointing up at the angle the puck went in at. I think that's going to be Kirkby's goal.
Three goals in the last two games for Tyson Kirkby, who's heating up at the right time for the Black Bears. And they follow up a goal from Columbus with one of their own. And Tyson Kirkby, I think, just knocked that down out of midair. Take a look at this angle from the Zamboni corner. And yeah, Kirkby with the tip at the right spot. And the Black Bears are back up by a pair.
And the guy we've been talking about all weekend, Brooks, Colin Fitzgerald with the primary assist.
Lopez now touching back up at the blue line, saucering it in down low for Samara, wanting a holding call. Not going to get one. Fitzgerald gets rewarded with an assist, and we have a penalty coming up.
Looks like
and
it's going to be a slash.
Yep, Samara's going to get the retaliation penalty call as he wanted a holding call, and then he gave the defender, who was holding his stick, an extra whack on the way through, and we talk about it all the time. It's not the first. It's always the retaliation call.
And Samara's a young guy, but you cannot have that in that situation. You just scored to go up two. You cannot give Columbus a free power play. You have to make them earn every inch. This is one of the best teams, if not the best team in the league, and you cannot give them a free power play on a dumb slash because you're frustrated.
Find out what happens after these messages. Black Bears up by two on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. Black Bears are on another Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. We'll see if they can do as good a job as they did last time. Puck, though, held in as Schultz tried to throw it right out of the zone immediately. Storja Hand throws a shot on. That never made it there. Columbus still searching for their first power play shot on goal of the night. Fitzgerald tries to paw it down, gets it on his forehand, and here's skate away with it. And Fitzgerald's going to take a run shorthanded, throws it on target. Penalty's coming up, and we're going to 4-on-4 as Joe Testa with the call.
I'll tell you what, Brooks, that was an incredibly good chance at goal. Pavlos did not see that at all coming, and Fitzgerald almost snuck it 5-hole on the penalty kill.
So now Columbus officially 0-for-2 on the power play. It'll be a minute 31 of 4-on-4 time. Then the Black Bears will have an abbreviated man-up opportunity.
As we see here on the Heinz Energy replay, I don't think the keeper saw that one, Brooks, until the very, very last minute. It looked, I think he thought Fitzgerald was going to try to flip his stick onto the forehand, take a shot from there. And Fitzgerald just threw a light backhand that he didn't pick up until it was literally on top of him.
So Columbus with no shots on goal on their first two power plays. Now, granted, that one was abbreviated. We'll see if 4-on-4 does them any better. Wickline can't handle the puck, and Oliveri taps it over to Lopez, dropping it back over for Oliveri. Low angle, looking for a screen out in front. He got one, and Pavlos made the save. Columbus gets the puck right back, and now Petrie skating across. Columbus is offsides, though, and frustration sitting in with this Columbus squad right now as they've been guilty of a couple of offsides infractions.
Well, when you're an aggressive team like Columbus is, they're really aggressive on their zone entries. They like to leak guys out there that we've seen multiple times so far this game, trying to sneak it out. you can get caught with those offsides where the guys are trying to get that just extra hair, that just extra second, just getting that extra inch into the zone. And the officials have caught it so far this game.
So Don Oliveri has picked up a secondary assist on the second Black Bears goal as Connor Smith gets a bump and he's taken down to the ice on a big hit from Columbus. Now Smith up at the line, 2-on-1 for the Black Bears. Smith, a slap shot, blocker save made by Pavlis. Still at 4-on-4. Schultz coming in, a wrister that was blocked by Petrie on the way through. Oliveri, soccer styles it over to Schultz. Schultz's pass across the ice is blocked by the Columbus goal scorer, Lane King. And back out into the neutral zone. Smith, fast skater, big size, coming in forehand, denied by Pavlis with a kick save, all the way back out to the red line. Jemayev goes off on a line change. Fitzgerald collects the loose change. Samaro's coming out in 5 seconds, and spun around is Fitzgerald, and pulled back by Gavin Yates. So we go from 4-on-4 to a Henny hard seltzer power play for the next 27 seconds. Samaro sprints off the ice, and Anderson will take his place. Abbreviated power play for the Black Bears. Oliveri across for Anderson. Couldn't backhand it over to Yates. Anderson tied up a little bit by Greco. And the Black Bears not being able to generate any 5-on-4 opportunity here. Looks like this power play is going to wind down as it's going to be poked back out into the neutral zone. So Binghamton will move to 1-for-2 on the power play tonight as time expires on the hooking minor. Joseph reversing it on the backhand for Boylar. Jurich couldn't find it, and this is a turnover. Petrantonio throws a shot on, steered aside by the goaltender. Kelly tries to center up off the skate of Jurich, and now Yates starts his engine. Black Bears will come in 3-on-3. Yates going wide, throws it on the brakes into the corner. Boylar is calling for the one-timer. Yates surveying his option, finds Boylar in the faceoff dot, throws it into the chest of the goaltender, cleaned up by the River Dragon defense. Come all the way back. No icing. They say Schultz took too long to make a decision there.
I think actually, Brooks, it's Taylor Joseph thought for half a second to go play that puck and made a motion forward, killing that icing.
All right. Thank you, Alex. Black Bears cross the line offsides as Lewis was just a hair early into the zone on the pass from Lopez. 10:48 left to go in the second period. Shots on goal, 24 for the Black Bears and 16 for the River Dragons. Both teams on the board in the frame. Black Bears with 2, Columbus with 1.
And Brooks, the physicality is really picked up for both teams. It's going to be interesting to see if there are any dumb penalties by Columbus as they become more and more frustrated with this Black Bears team really keeping the pressure on them on 200 feet of ice.
Lewis trying to center up. He made a man fall at the line. Couldn't get a shot on goal as a defenseman was able to block it going long body style. Now, possible odd man opportunity for the River Dragons. Thorjahan going up against Boylar. Tries to use the defenseman as a screen. He throws the shot wide of the target. Now for go, right back up to the blue line. Storjahan reversing it over for Jemayev. Schultz and Jemayev, two big boys, tie up with each other on the boards, leaving it over for Mac Lewis. Parker touches up. Lopez is offsides, as I guess they say that Parker bounced it back out of the zone for the goaltender, for the forward to play the puck.
Yeah, and that's a tough one, Brooks. The Black Bears were coming in with quite a bit of momentum there. Unfortunately, Parker's not able to corral the puck as he goes across the blue line and able to, make it safely into the zone.
Oliveri way back in the defensive zone for the Black Bears as this puck is dropped in the neutral zone. He will skate forward, grab some momentum, try to stick handle into the zone. Instead, Connor Smith throws it on target. Pavlis steers it into the corner with his paddle. Now for go, playing it over to Day, and Columbus starts their engine. Aldworth run into by Oliveri. Those two not playing with each other before. Anderson with a wrap check as a shot's going to be blocked out into the neutral zone. Can Stanko catch up to it? He cannot. Played all the way back to the Binghamton blue line. Anderson fanned on his first pass. Stick handling in a phone booth goes off the wall to Smith. Smith across ice over for Stanko. A wrist shot is absorbed. Blocked by Anderson out in front. The way that Pavlis reacted, I thought he had it.
I think he thought he had it too, Brooks.
And Smith applying pressure on the forecheck. It's going to be intercepted by Fitzgerald. They touch up. They're on sides. Can Smith lift from behind? Steals the puck right back for the Black Bears. A man going down to the ice for Columbus as Fergo plays it too far in front of Day. All the way back over for Schultz. Cross ice. Yates touching up. Trying to saucer over to Jurich. Too far out in front of 22 dressed in red, white, and blue with a lot of black as well. Kirkby in the slot throws it to the front of the net. Vanelli blocked it on the way through. Columbus comes back the other way. Tempo picking up here, but Trentonio tries to saucer it out in front. Moore colliding with Kirkby, got their skates twisted up. Heavy hit laid on by Greco. Gavin Yates has lost his helmet. A little bit of a late shove on Yates as he didn't have his helmet. Play will continue. Yates gets off. Petrantonio holds it in at the line. One-timer from Vanelli. Blocker saved by Joseph. It's high into the air. We continue to play on. Schultz now outside the trapezoid. Leaves it for Kirkby. There's a black helmet out on the ice. Fitzgerald will float it out into the neutral zone, and the Black Bears get it out of Dodge. Lewis dropping it back for Jurich. Through traffic, Jurich's shot is blocked temporarily by Lewis. In front, second opportunity is cleaned up by the River Dragons. And now LaBelle skating across the line, dropped it back for Kelly. Cross ice behind for Trentonio. Slap shot from Moore. Trailing the play is denied. Columbus barking out assignments right now coming from the bench. They're a little out of position. And now Boylar coming across the line. Leaving it over for Parker, tries to get to his forehand, put it wide of the target. Samero was covering for the defenseman. Now he's skating backwards against Storjahan. Storjahan's pass too far ahead of Jemayev. And now cross ice over to Samero. Samero crossing over, back in the lineup tonight after sitting last night. Boylar trying to get it deep. He failed, but it worked out for the Black Bears. And now Boylar at the blue line throws a shot, looking for a tip, blocked out in front by Petrie. Storjahan crossing over the line. Heavy hits being laid on by both teams here in tonight's contest. You could tell it's a rubber match with a playoff intensity feel here tonight as the regular season is winding down. Samero chip and charge after it. Lays a hit on Vanelli. Lopez tries to get it on his forehand, spins off a hit, trying to send it up for Samero. Out in front, he scores! What a hustle play by the Black Bears.
And an excellent handle by Chad Lopez, who put that puck directly on Samero's stick. Samero puts in the back of the net for his third goal of the year.
Justin Samero all the way from New Hampshire. His third of the season, as Alex said, puts the Black Bears up by 3. Third goal of the period for Binghamton. And Chad Lopez now with a 2-point night. See if they give out a secondary assist on that one as well. I believe it would belong to Brett Parker. Let's hear what Ben has to say. Stanko coming in across the line. His shot go end over end. And now Columbus coming the other way. Day crossing over the line. Columbus is on sides, and he's sent down to the ice by Coachman.
I believe Coachman just gave him the Pat Beverly treatment there, Brooks. As Columbus handles the puck in the neutral zone, trying to get it in, tipped into the defensive zone of the Black Bears.
That's also a Burger King burger goal, so that means all of our friends are going home with vouchers for a free Burger King cheeseburger at participating locations. Second night in a row for the Black Bears. Now they have gotten to the 4-goal mark. Now Kyle Moore coming out of the line change. Coming in on Joseph, shot denied. Kick save made by Joseph. Oliveri couldn't clear the puck out of the zone, still behind the Black Bears net. Centering out in front for Petrantonio, and here's score. Grabbing a little bit of momentum back as Columbus grabs their second goal. Black Bears on the failed clear, couldn't get it out, and it leads to a Columbus goal.
And that's been a problem for the Black Bears all this season. When they fail to get the puck out of the zone, which they have at times, it often leads to goals. Unfortunately for the Black Bears, this is the case. Allowing Columbus getting back into a 2-goal game.
Samero's goal came at the 13:20 mark.
As the Black Bears win the draw.
Yep, and I'm trying to do the math very quickly in my head as that puck is going to be fluttered up high into the air. Fitzgerald will chase, push the puck back out into the zone. They're onside. Pietrantonio leaves it over for Kelly. That shot's blocked. The Black Bear down on the ice is Colin Fitzgerald. The referees will intervene, blow the play dead, and Fitzgerald is going to skate right off. We're going to have a media timeout. We're checking in on Colin Fitzgerald. River Dragons back on the board, their second of the night. Binghamton up to four as it's a two-goal lead for the Black Bears on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. And Colin Fitzgerald has gone to the locker room after catching a stick up high on a follow-through.
Yeah, Brooks, on the follow-through, that shot caught it right in the mouth. Immediately saw him go to the ice, grab something, and head to the locker room. You don't want to speculate at all, but you might think it looked like one of the more common injuries in hockey, and it looks like he might have lost a tooth there.
5:12 left to go. Looks like this will be a neutral zone faceoff coming up. Josh Pietrantonio, the captain of the River Dragons with his 16th of the season, makes it a two-goal game. Afterward, Justin Samaro extended it to a three-goal lead, but that only lasted for a minute and 5 seconds.
And now, Brooks, a huge thing as well. Black Bears down to four defensemen.
Yep, that's part of the gamble when you dress five. It's worked out offensively for the Black Bears as you get more guys involved. But you have a situation like that, you're down to four defensemen. Yates' shot is wide off of the faceoff as the Black Bears entered the zone cleanly. Yates trying to stay on the forecheck, but it'd be sockered away by LaBelle. LaBelle cross ice onto the tape of Kelly. 2-on-1, a shot wide of the target off the glass, trying to beat Joseph to the high blocker. Coachman and Kelly fight for it down low. Coachman plays it off the wall and gets out of the zone at the red line, touched up by Greco. Kelly will FIFA this one off target slightly, but Joseph will paw it down as Gavin Yates will come the other way all by himself, try to dump it in across the boards. Tyler Jurich gets a little bit of a takeaway. He's behind the net trying to center up for Yates. Too far behind his teammate. And now Columbus comes the other way. Storjahan cutting through the middle of the ice. Late developing 2-on-1 as Jemayev tried to throw it out to Storjahan out in front of the net. Rogers a shot tipped out in front by King down on the ice, but it'll hop into the netting and out of play with 4:06 left to go. A rare occasion. We got back-to-back media timeouts, but final stretch of the second period coming up after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton, and Alex Columbus, the latest goal scorers in this one. I feel like it's that much more important for the Black Bears to get to the locker room in the final 4 minutes and change at a two-goal lead, if not better.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. Carry that momentum into the third period. Really put Columbus on their back foot. You got a defensive zone draw. You got to go. got to get this into your hands if you're the Black Bears and start your breakout.
Faceoff won by the Black Bears as Samero comes forward with it. He's the last Binghamton goal scorer. As Pavlis wraps it around the boards, can it be held in by Lopez? It cannot. Oliveri on his forehand. Plays it back over to Samero. Nice thick handling from Samero and Lopez to get it over into the corner. Lopez now behind the net, centers up, out in front, and another save made by Pavlis with the pad. Pavlis standing on his head here as Binghamton now up to 27 shots on goal. Better shooting period for Columbus this frame as well, as they are already past their total. They have at least 12, and they have 3:30 left to add on some more. Villar plays it off the wall for Logar. And Logar now across the red line. Lost his handle on it. Rogers had his pocket picked, and Logar stopping and starting. He was one of the extra guys out there on the ice tonight. Boylar fanned on a shot, but recovered a little bit. Storjahan could not complete the pass. That would have been a breakaway all alone.
That would have been a 3-on-0, Brooks.
Yeah, so we'll see if the Black Bears can gap up defensively here. Storjahan back up to the point. Vanelli shot blocked by Logar. It'll hop out of the zone, forcing Columbus to touch up. Some fresh bodies coming out on the ice. Mac Lewis skating right out of the gate to try to join the defensive group. Fitzgerald, no, excuse me, that's Oliveri, lost his stick. We're trying to get an update on Fitzgerald when we get to intermission. It's a four-man pileup right in front of the Columbus bench near the red line, and the referees will intervene as neither side wanted to move the puck. It'll be a neutral zone faceoff with 2:33 left to go.
And that's a heady veteran play right there. Oliveri realizing he doesn't have a stick. He's a defenseman trying to get back into the zone. That could have led to an odd man rush. I'm going to kill this puck right here, eat some time. Let us get to this intermission. Really smart play and heady veteran play by Don Oliveri.
Lewis wins the faceoff back cleanly to the captain, Jake Schultz. And now Connor Smith tries to connect on a stretch pass. Too far in front.
Oh, bad. Before the whistle blew on that one, Brooks, I gotta say the official got that one wrong. That hit the keeper's stick. I think maybe he was calling simultaneous touching up the as it happened. But that's
tie goes to the defense.
I understand that, Brooks. That looks even a little bit on the goaltender's end, but I understand what the officials are looking for there. They also don't want guys racing down the ice, which is what led to a lot of injuries in the past.
19 versus 19 on the faceoff, Lewis and Oldworth. Schultz will win it back from the wing position. Now the Black Bears tasked with getting it out of the zone, floated back out to neutral ice. They do so. And now Mac Lewis has it on his backhand. Schultz runs to his own man, stays on his feet, throws it on target, and Pavlis has to make a standing blocker save. As now the Black Bears try to look for more. Anderson shot, tipped just wide at the last second.
I thought that was in the back of the net, Brooks. From our vantage point, that looked like a goal.
Under 2 minutes left to go here in period number two. Columbus trying to spring a leak off the stick of Jay Krupp. No icing here. Centers up for Day, nobody there. It's a turnover, Connor Smith coming the other way. Smith on his forehand, toe drag, taken down from behind. Actually, I believe he lost his edge instead. Back out into the Black Bears zone. Anderson will just throw it off the boards while the Black Bears are in the midst of a line change. Yates going across, toe drag on the forehand.
Off the crossbar, Brooks.
Top of the pipe, right into the netting. Actually, that might have gone over the safety netting. That went off the top of the crossbar straight up into the air. And it looks like it did bounce back in play.
That hit Crost, upper right corner, Brooks, a millimeter away from being a beautiful goal from Gavin Yates.
1:21 left to go. Take a look at the Heinz Energy replay. Once again, Black Bears beat the goalie but could not beat the heavy metal. Now Kirkby. Offensive zone faceoff, one back to Boylar. Wrist shot, kick save, Pavlis into the corner. Back up to the line for Boylar. He steers it on the backhand. Nobody in the bumper spot for the Black Bears. That's Juric, steals it right back. Kirkby coming on in. Saucered across for Yates, got a piece of it, but not enough. Kirkby tries a wrap chance. Oliveri in the slot, still has it on his stick. Yates a shot high. Now behind the net, Boylar will pinch in. Wrap check style for Columbus, trying to get it out of the zone. Petrangelo is successful. Kirkby throws on the brakes at the blue line defensively onto the blade of Gavin Yates. Over to Kirkby, right wing side, on the backhander, out in front, and down in the splits. Pavlis made the save. 3-on-2 opportunity for Columbus, going the other way. Popped high into the air. Kelly touches up, and Columbus is offsides with 27 seconds left to go.
And just, I mean, Brooks, what more can you say? There's nothing you can say about that save. It was so incredibly close to going. I believe it went off a River Dragon. Right in front of the net, right there, yep.
Yeah, I think it went off LaBelle.
And just an incredible split save to be able to go across like that. This shows why the River Dragons is one of the best teams in the league.
Yep. Pavlis' record 6-1-2 as a goaltender of record this season. Columbus with only 9 regulation losses, one of two teams with single-digit defeats this season. Jemayev up at the red line, steers it on the backhand. 10 seconds left to go. Black Bears get it out one more time. Final push, though, for Columbus as Storjahan comes in. Can the Black Bears push it into the wall? That's going to be the horn. And Binghamton carries a 2-goal lead into the locker room as they are up 4-2 after 40 minutes of play.
Yeah, an incredibly intense period for both teams. A lot of offensive chances on either end of the ice, really upping their shots, and just one of the best periods of pure hockey we've seen so far here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena.
All right, we have another Excite Motorsports intermission report getting ready to come up. We have the Excite Motorsports Chuck-a-Puck as well going on tonight, as it is customary here for the second period intermission report. Back with you in just a little bit. Black Bears up by a pair when we come back. More intermission report hockey after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
Your Binghamton Black Bears are headed back to the Commissioner's Cup playoffs for the 2023 season. Playoff tickets are on sale now. You can purchase them on the third floor of the Vision Veterans Memorial Arena by calling 607-722-7367 or visiting Ticketmaster.com. The Binghamton Black Bears, in conjunction with the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame, are proud to announce 3 inductees into the 2023 Hall of Fame. Come early to the Black Bears game on Friday, April 7th, to see Josh Hennessy, Patrice Robitaille, and the late Charlie Jaworski officially be inducted into the Binghamton Hockey Hall of Fame. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Bricks Barber Company Clip of the Week.
Time, getting the puck out of their zone. Takeaway for Josh Newberg. Samero scores, cashing in his first goal at home as a Black Bear, second as a professional hockey player.
Bricks Barber Company, located in the number 5 Commons at 41 South Washington Street, right here in downtown Binghamton. Give them a visit today.
If you're looking to install a beautiful, durable, and handcrafted countertop, call Alice James Construction. The Southern Tier's most trusted stone fabrication will design and install your dream countertop and let you choose from a premium selection of natural stones like marble, granite, or quartzite. Stone or granite countertops starting as low as $35 per square foot installed. Schedule your free quote and receive a free sink with your countertop project. Call 607-275-5495.
Pilsner.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2 and 3 bedroom units fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Magic 101.7.
The best radio station.
Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever.
Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol, cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired. And it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
Into the slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at BinghamtonBlackBears.com.
Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
now up by 3 over Mississippi, 6-3. Danbury up by a pair. They lead Elmira 4-2 on the road. And Delaware leads Watertown on the road, 1-0. So Thunder over the Wolves, 1-0. Hat Tricks over Mammoth, 4-2. Thunderbirds over Seawolves, 6-3. And Rockers over Prowlers, 5-4. That's a look at our out-of-town scoreboard. When we come back, we'll have the third period presented by American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. Welcome back into Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton and the third period on YouTube at the Binghamton Black Bears channel. Brooks Hill, Alex Jones here with you tonight. And we talked about it during the Excite Motorsports intermission report. You got Columbus on the ropes, but are you going to let them get out of the corner with a slip and counter right back? Or are you going to go for the knockout punch here in the third period?
I'm going to be honest. I expect the Black Bears to get out after Columbus early and often get really aggressive here. Smartly aggressive, however, you know, not taking too many over the top chances while also allowing them to really put pressure on Columbus and not allow them to spend much time in the Black Bears zone. I think we've seen that all game so far, and I expect it to stay the same.
Third period getting ready to start, brought to you by our friends over at American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. They are built to a higher standard as the River Dragons coming out of the tunnel now. We will start at 5-on-5. It's been one penalty per team per period so far. We'll see if that trend continues. April Fool's Day, first responder night. No joke, Black Bears are playing some of their best hockey this weekend as they make the final push before the playoffs. Taylor Joseph looking sturdy in net. He's got 18 saves so far. Christian Pavlos, 27 to his name. It's a 4-2 contest. Columbus can get to 5. They average 4.9 a game. It'll just be, can Binghamton add on some more? We're officially underway with the third period. Turnover right off the rip. Schultz, a wrist shot, knocked up into the air. Oliveri can't bat it out of midair. And Anderson giving chase to Moore on the way through. Kyle Moore wraps it behind. Joseph will stop it, play it off the glass, trying to find Stanko. Stanko throws a chop at it. Petrantonio, low angle, looking for a deflection, doesn't get one. Back over to Rogers, has to soccer style it to stay in the zone, but look out. Could have been a stretch pass. Stanko couldn't connect on it, and the goaltender steers it, directs the offense out for Columbus. Anderson at the blue line, couldn't keep it in. Now Columbus at the center marker, throws it on target, and Joseph had to make the save. Jemayev now matched up against Stanko, and size advantage to Jemayev that time, as that one's going to be poked out in front. Joseph electing to play the puck off the boards. Kirkby with a deceptive play, now coming in the right wing side. Saucer over for Yates, and Pavlis coming to the top of his crease to go down in the splits and make the save with the leg. Don't see that too often. A goaltender leaping forward to make a leg save.
And I think, Brooks, that's on Yates' stick if he doesn't do that.
Boylar behind his own net will cut in front in between the hashes. Play it over for Jurich. Coming down the right wing side, Jurich crosses over all three lines. Yates on the trailer, Boylar's shot. I believe it was tipped on the way through. Pavlis might have got a piece of it. Binghamton's going to touch up on the delayed offsides. Lopez too far in front of Jurich, but Yates blocks a pass, keeps it in temporarily. Floated back out into the middle third of the ice. As now Boylar gives chase right after. Lopez over to Yates. Those two very quick skaters. Yates in the corner over skating. It was still at his feet. Instead, it was behind him. Columbus coming the other way. Aldworth trying to drag around Coachman. No quarter given by the man who recently celebrated a birthday. Boards, bottom of the glass actually. Gets it in down low. Hold on to the puck and the offensive side for some sustained pressure. Now Aldworth coming in. His shot blocked on the way through. Wickline, Coachman battle for it, and Wickline gets pinned up by Coachman in the corner. And now Parker, self-pass, tries to get back over to it. Two on one. Parker's shot blocker save made by Pavlis as it gets deflected into the corner. Now Kyle Moore coming out. Fitzgerald back out on the ice after missing the last 5 minutes of the second period. Good to see him back out, 15 in black. Made a good play, sealing Moore away. Fitzgerald taking some time off the clock. A long way to go here in a two-goal contest. Wants the breakout the right way.
I mean, the Black Bears just content to sit there and let the puck sit. I mean, the officials aren't going to call it. It's in play. He has the puck on a stick. In fact, Columbus is the one ruining their own time and chance at goal opportunities by letting the Black Bears just stand behind the net.
16:35 left to go here in the period as that shot from Jake Schultz is deflected out of play, goes off the top of the netting. It lands back in the goal crease.
Just an excellent shot by Schultz there, allowing the Black Bears to get an offensive zone face-up as Anderson steps up to take the draw. Wins it, ends up on Smith's stick. Great shot by Smith.
Yeah, as that puck's going to be floated down length of the ice. This is icing against Columbus after Smith put a great shot on target. River Dragons just want that puck out of the zone and away from Connor Smith. As it looks like Anderson's now talking to Oliveri and Fitzgerald about the way that they should line up. Looks like they're going to switch to the one-timing side instead of being on the forehand side against the wall. Tie up by Smith and a member of the River Dragons. Petrie was down on the ice, and this could be a two-on-one coming the other way. Shot in a block by Fitzgerald, diving all the way out in front of it.
Kick saving a beaut there, Brooks.
Yeah, I don't know if you can credit a save to Fitzgerald on that, but he went sliding across, got his foot up in the air, and sent it into the netting.
Yeah, an excellent, excellent hustle play by Fitzgerald, who's been one of the most unselfish guys on this team since he's joined the Black Bears. And as we look at the Heinz Energy replay, Fitzgerald doing an excellent job forcing the River Dragon to commit by blocking both the passing and shooting lane.
Faceoff is pushed back. Fitzgerald gets over to a loose puck on a centering attempt by Columbus. Onto the tape of Smith coming the other way. Anderson over to Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald scores! His second of the season! Have a night, Colin Fitzgerald. He will not be denied. And the Black Bears back up by 3.
And you can't help but love it from Colin Fitzgerald getting hit in the face earlier in the game. really pumping the crowd up. You could see him, if you watch the replay of the wide angle, you see him jump up on the rush. An excellent job by the forward in the middle of the ice, recognizing that Fitzgerald was to his left. I believe that's Jesse Anderson. Anderson puts it on his stick. Fitzgerald handles the rest. 5-2 Black Bears, 15:59 left in the third period. Kirkby loses the draw for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Aldworth and Kirkby, teammates last year in this Binghamton squad. Remember, during the summer, it was a one-for-one trade. Jake Schultz for Tommy Aldworth. Aldworth going to Columbus, Schultz coming to Binghamton. Don't want to say either team really won or lost the trade because both guys are doing good for their respective clubs. Schultz coming a little bit closer to home as he's a Rochester native. And Aldworth getting a little bit more ice time. As Yates down on a knee, he was getting peppered by Greco on the way through, coming back across for a call instead of staying with the play. And Greco and Yates still tied up. Jurich centers out in front for Kirkby. Puck squirts into the blue paint, and Pavlis will melt it down. 5:14 left to go, but circling back to that trade, beneficial for both teams. The Black Bears get a great defenseman.
I think it's one of those trades similar to the Stephon Diggs trade that ended up getting the Vikings in football. Justin Jefferson, it's a team that you're, hey, we're happy with. We do that trade all over again. Schultz has been a constant presence on the defensive line. Allsworth's been incredible for the Columbus River Dragons.
Well, Joe Testa talking to the Black Bears bench right now.
I think what they're looking for is clarification why wasn't called interference when there was a Columbus defender draped all over Yates.
Jonathan Polanco drops the puck back, and Jake Schultz misfires a slap shot. Goes wide of the target.
Skate through, Brooks.
Okay, well, Yates now in the corner, has it on his forehand, finds Schultz wide open. There's a heavy slap shot from the captain. Stays in play off the glass. Boylar tries a soft backhander over for Yates. He can't connect, and the River Dragons will go the other way. 4-on-3 for Go. Tries a drag around Schultz instead. A good back check by Jurich. Knocks the puck off of his stick. Held in, though, at the blue line by Columbus. And a down in the splits. Drifting away, Joseph makes the glove save, taking us to our first media timeout of the third period. Black Bears back up by 3, thanks to Colin Fitzgerald. Back with you after these messages on Fox 1430.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. Black Bears find themselves now up by 3 thanks to Colin Fitzgerald's second goal of the season. And we've been saying his name all night long. A 2-point night for Fitzgerald, now with a goal and an assist. 14:40 left to go. And Alex, we talked about it coming back in from the intermission report that the Black Bears could either let Columbus hang around, slip out of the corner, or they could go for some heavy punches and maybe try to deliver the knockout blow in this third period.
Yeah, and that's exactly what the Black Bears did. First off, Colin Fitzgerald sacrificing on the defensive end as Lopez wins this draw for the Black Bears, and then getting on that rush and really throwing the haymaker that was his goal.
Jemayev steers it on the backhand, intercepted by Lopez, tries a self-pass off the wall. It's cut down. And they're going to say that the play is still on sides as it was thrown towards the net. Joseph will just snatch it out of midair and hang on for a whistle.
Great job by Joseph melting that down. We got the Heinz Energy replay here. Huge shot, and as Joseph, that's a tough, tough save for a goalie to make. You don't want to deflect it out. Get it on, get it into your trapper. Make sure the Columbus River Dragons don't get a second opportunity on it.
Oliveri takes a loose puck and floats it out into the neutral zone. Lopez, skate to stick, behind the net, trying to connect with Stanko, I believe. Oliveri, spin cycle, still has it on his tape. Puts it a little off target, maybe looking for a tip out in front.
I think Oliveri faked everybody, including Connor Smith, on that one, Brooks.
Yeah, hard to keep up with Oliveri's stick handling abilities. You never know if it's going towards the net or going right to your stick. Pretty accurate with both. Oliveri now behind his own net. Starts the breakout. And now Samara with a goal tonight. Right on the tape of Jesse Anderson. Anderson one on three. Gets a little bit of help from Logar, but passes behind Logar, and it comes right back out for Columbus. Aldworth coming in. He's going to try a one-handed pass out in front. Nobody home for Columbus. Finds its way into the corner. Now Fitzgerald. Latest goal scorer in the game. Cross ice over for Smith. Smith sidesteps Greco once again, and Smith's shot is blocked partially, and it falls into the netting and out of play.
And an excellent move there. Get a shot on net by the Black Bears, really keeping the pressure going as Columbus got a little bit of zone, offensive zone time. The Black Bears counter, bring it down, get the offensive zone faceoff off their own. Smith, Anderson, and Stanko out there with Schultz and Fitzgerald. A deadly combination of lines so far this game.
Yeah, and Greco has tried to lay a heavy hit on Connor Smith twice tonight, and he's missed both times with the old school hip check. Now Greco with a little bit of a hook and hold, not penalty wise, but on the stick of Smith. Those two going back and forth with each other. Behind the net now, Wickline.
Colin Fitzgerald guarding two guys defensively.
Yeah, that'll allow Jake Schultz to scoot over to the loose puck, and Binghamton gets it out of the zone. Now Jesse Anderson comes across the line. He takes a hit, but Smith does have it temporarily. Stretch pass too far in front of Moore. Joseph comes out of his net to nullify the icing. Played out in front. Binghamton maybe trying to counter quickly as Stanko puts it over for Schultz. Cross ice pass. Over for Oliveri. Throws on the brakes, tries to work it back to the blue line for Smith. Unsuccessful try for Binghamton that time. And for go now coming back into the Black Bear zone. Centers up. Kelly, a shot save. Joseph down in the butterfly, and they're going to say that goes out of play, and that's going to actually fall right in front of the door where all the assistant equipment managers and the scratchers are hanging out.
Yeah, and Brooks, it was one of those where you lost the puck completely until you see two guys get into it close to the board. You're like, ah, puck's got to be over there. That's why they're tying them up.
For Trantonio and Kirkby going at it. Two guys in the leadership group for their respective clubs. And Kirkby's asked out.
Linesman didn't like the answer he gave when he asked him to adjust his feet.
Durich will just try to poke it forward for Kirkby. A wrister from the blue line from for go is easily snared by Joseph, and we're reset, do it again.
Yeah, an excellent job by Joseph there. That would have been a tasty, tasty rebound for Columbus. Melt the puck down. Let your guys get into the faceoff dot.
So now Kirkby can come back like nothing happened. Centerman tie up. Loose puck finds its way over to Don Oliveri, who plays it off the wall for Tyler Jurich. Gavin Yates, up and the blue line. One ups it for Tyson Kirkby. Kirkby tries to get around a Columbus defender. Loose handling out in front. Kirkby trying to outweigh the goaltender. It pops up high. This is touched with a high stick, but Kirkby plays on. Oliveri paws it down, holds it in the line, floats it up towards the net. And now back up to the line for Boylar. Down low for Jurich. Jurich saucers it over for Yates. A little bit of a misfire. Boylar, slap shot. Can't be held onto by the Columbus goaltender, but it makes its way back out to the red line. Kelly, cross corner dumping over to Jay Krupp. Coming in, diving effort, out in front. Where's the puck? They say it stays out. Krupp does not believe it.
What an amazing save by Taylor Joseph, laying it all out on the line.
Right on the goal line. Aldworth sidesteps a heavy hit from Parker. Low angle shot blocked by Boylar into the netting. Out of play with 10:57 left to go. I can't wait to see this Heinz Energy replay. I have no idea how that puck stayed out.
And it looks like Coach Sherwood isn't either at this point. Honestly, We got the cam on him right now, looking around the arena. What an amazing save, both by Taylor Joseph and an excellent job by Gavin Yates. Diving, getting the stick around on the stick of Krupp, not allowing him to get the best opportunity he could. And Krupp is, as you can tell, Brooks, not happy with that one.
10:57 left to go here. And now Lopez will face off with Aldworth. Aldworth tried to push it forward, just like Lopez does when he has it. That puck going end over end off the skate of Schultz, and I believe a Columbus player as well, makes its way on target. Let's take a look at the Heinz Energy replay. Right in the corner. Watch that black puck stay all the way through.
And Kirkby's the one who ends up clearing it right in front of Taylor Joseph.
Good camera work from our friends over in the video room. Puck does not cross that red line. Stays out.
So we get back to live action. The Black Bears lost the draw, but are able to get the puck out of their zone.
Yep. 10:35 left to go here in period number three. Black Bears staying on the forecheck. Cross-ice pass in front of Storjahan. He tries to run it down. Good stick by Justin Coachman to just knock it away. Live to fight another day. And Coachman gets it right back. Coachman, the acquiree from Watertown, back in December, earlier this season. Lopez now coming in, sidesteps a man. Look at him go, out in front. Stuff chance opportunity denied by Pavlis. Lopez stays on the forecheck. Three-man cycle back up to the line for Fitzgerald. Loading it up for Boyd Lahr. Tipped on by Parker, steered aside. Petrie, a little bit of a nudge from Parker down as he pushes it across Wick line. Nudged by Boyd Lahr, and interference is going to be the call. Columbus headed back to the power play. And you can tell Mac Lewis trying to calm down his teammate. You don't need a minor turn into a double. Crowd will boo at it. Find out what happens when we come back on Fox 1430.
It's time for the Matthews Collision Center collision of the game.
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton as they do the happy birthday promotion here. Guys treating me to a good game on the eve of my 25th birthday. Glad I could be sharing it here with you, Alex, as well. Black Bears up 5-2 with 9:49 left to go here in period number three.
And that was very clearly an interference on Boyd Lahr. He waited too long to play the man after the puck was already gone.
Fitzgerald gets over to a loose puck, and they will slap it down the length of the ice. 2 minutes for interference, and like Alex said, we got a look at the replay while we were away at commercial, and the crowd will boo and jeer at it, but that's the right call. Boyd Lahr playing the man not near the puck. Same thing happens at the National League level all the time. Columbus over two on the power play, though, desperately trying to get one and grab some momentum for a final push. Kelly, a shot caught by Joseph at the top of his crease and held on to.
Also the first power play shot by Columbus, 9:17 left in the third. That's never a good situation for your power play when you don't have a shot until halfway through the third period.
Yeah. If there was an immediate timeout right before that power play, I think Coach Bouchard calls timeout, try to settle down the troops, talking about, hey, like, this is a very important situation right here. But he got a free one essentially during that media break. LaBelle at the top of the umbrella, four down low as Kelly fakes going into the faceoff. Dot throws a shot through traffic. Samero tries to find it after he blocked the initial drive on as King now. Started the scoring for Columbus, puts it back for LaBelle. Slap pass looking for a tip out in front. And a penalty is coming up. We got both referees' arms up in the air.
Looks like it's going to be offsetting, Brooks, because it's going to be on 12 and on Schultz. Goaltender interference and cross-check on Schultz.
So Jake Schultz headed over to the penalty box, and so is Alex Jemeth. See if this will stay 5-on-4 or go down to 4-on-3.
And, I mean, that's one from Schultz you'll take there. You got to stick up for your goalie. Can't have guys crash in the net like that, making contact with the keeper's head. Just an unfortunate situation for the Black Bears, as Taylor Joseph has been playing exceptional so far this game. And now you're down to 4 defensemen once again.
No, excuse me, check that. You're down to 3 because you have Boylar and now Schultz in the penalty
correct,
box.
Correct. You're right, Brooks. Taylor Joseph getting up, saluting the crowd a little bit. Glad to see he's okay. Getting some water real quick. See here on the Hines end replay what really... That's pretty as blatant as you could... 12-4. Columbus Kelly drives the net, makes head contact with Taylor Joseph. And they're going to call that 10 times out of 10 on goal.
Yeah, so we're going to stay at 5-on-4. We're working on getting those penalties up on the board. They both occur at 11-11. Jake Schultz gets the retaliation call for cross-checking. The initial call goes against Alex Jemeth. He gets 2 for goaltender interference. Georgia Hand ushered out. And Day now back over to Vannelli. Clean win for Columbus as Storja Hand loads it up. Misfire by Vannelli. Coachman on the backhand will rise it all the way down back to Pavlis. Continue. Oh, excuse me, 4 minutes for roughing. All right, so once that gets up on the board. All right, there he goes. Vince Berruti on the PA tonight. A little egregious on that call. Instead of a double minor, it's just a regular minor for roughing and not a cross check. So for everybody keeping track at home, that's how it'll stay. And Krupp centering out in front for Day, too far in front. 20 seconds left to go in the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. Vannelli shot through traffic. Joseph made the save, still available. Rebound, trying to get cleaned up by Lagar. He's fighting from his knees to get over to the loose puck. Coachman lending a hand, Storja Hand out in front. He had his shot blocked by Oliveri. Now Day down low, Boylar up and ready. He has returned. Columbus 0-for-3 on the power play tonight. They still have the puck. Petrangelo, a shot tipped in, out in front. Joseph wants to talk with the official, saying that it was batted out of air with a high stick. But it looks like Jay Krupp will grab the goal at the end of the man advantage. It'll be an even strength goal. And Columbus back within a pair with 7:42 left to go.
And let's see on the Hines Energy replay here, Brooks. The guys in the video room do such an amazing job for us. Let's slow-mo. That's a good hockey goal right there. That's below the crossbar.
All right, the Black Bears have done a good job of answering Columbus goals with one of their own. We're back to 5-on-5, as we were when that goal was scored. So it's an even strength tally for Columbus. And Jay Krupp gets the assist. Black Bears now on the forecheck. And Storja Hand with the secondary helper. Lewis plays it over to Oliveri. Oliveri slap shot, misses everything. Fitzgerald has it ride his stick. He gets double teamed, and look out, Aldworth coming in. Can Oliveri get back? Oliveri does a good job nullifying the pass. Aldworth tried to stuff it up high. I believe Joseph got a piece of it. Aldworth centering up, stolen on the way through by Logar, and the Black Bears push it back out into neutral ice. 7 minutes left to go here in a good one. 2-goal game between Columbus and Binghamton. It's the rubber match. Both teams have won one game in overtime earlier back in March down in Georgia. Jurich up at the blue line. Tries to dump it in, doesn't get everything on as he tried to flick it into the corner. Rogers had it knocked away by Yates. And now Columbus gets it out of the zone. Krupp coming in, 2-on-2 opportunity. Tries to go around Coachman, instead uses him as a screen. He's sent down to the ice on the follow-through. Kirkby trying to play it over. What? They're on sides still, and Rodgers knew that he had to be the first one to touch it as he played it with his hand. Clock continues to run. 6:15 left to go here in this one. Yates sealed off against the boards. Can he get it outside the line? He does. And for go. Now back up to the line for Moore. Moore throws one on target. Boy, Lars sent Krupp down to the ice again, and after Krupp has scored that latest goal, he's been a little bit of a punching bag for the Black Bears. Here now, Jurich crossing over. Yates out in front, Saucer underneath his stick at the last second. Jurich behind the net, waiting for some friends. Big body throws it to the side of the goal. I believe Pablis got a save on it if it was out in front. Moore at the red line, dumps it in, and will go off for a line change. Stanko calls off the goaltender. Gets a little bit of a pick from Oliveri. He's peppered from behind by Day. Now Fitzgerald calmly takes some time, met with pressure from Storjahan, and Fitzgerald will circle his own wagon and reverse it all the way across for Anderson. Here comes the forecheck from Day. Day, though, steals it away from Anderson. Good recovery by Fitzgerald. Playing it up, it's a turnover. Greco tried to tip it from Day, and Joseph made the save. A little too close for comfort right there for the Black Bears. 5:08 left to go here in the third period, Alex.
Yeah, and as the penalties release, you get that fifth defenseman back. The Black Bears getting a little too cute in their own end right there. You'd like to see them just get that puck down the ice, even if it results in an icing. At least get the puck down so you can clear it.
We had a premature honk of the horn. We are going to stay right here. No media timeout.
It's like we have King in the faceoff dot for the River Dragons.
So yeah, the way that he's holding his stick looks like he wanted to go four, but wins it cleanly back to Greco. Greco waiting for the offensive players to get set up for Columbus. They had two men behind the net. And Schultz is doing a good job boxing out. This will hop over the stick of LaBelle. And now Connor Smith coming all the way down, forcing Pavlis to come out of his net to play it. LaBelle dumps it in, same corner. End up behind the net. Joseph sets it up for Schultz to play it over for Stanko. Now Anderson starts his engines. Got a man open cross ice, but knocked down by King right at the center ice mark. Stanko steals it right back. We're going the other way. Anderson coming in. Slap shot, kick save made by Pavlis. 41 shots left. Turnover as Binghamton has control, but Anderson dropped it back with nobody home. Columbus goes the other way. King waiting for friends. Coming in from the line change. Throws it down low for Storjahan as Boylar puts it into the corner. Storjahan down low. Centers off the back of the net. Boylar tries to get it on his forehand. It's intercepted. Rogers now at the blue line. Waiting, looking for a tip. It's poked wide. 4 minutes left to go. And now the puck down low for Petrie. Kelly out waiting Smith. Blockered away by Joseph. Tie up in the corner with Oliveri and Wickline. Right back on Aldwersdick. Tries a turnaround opportunity. Missing it on the short side. Oliveri gets to a loose puck. And this is a delayed offside. Stretch pass over for Stanko. Coming in, trying to outskate Columbus. Throws it on target. But Pavlis with the easy save. Couldn't get everything on that one. We got a penalty coming up. And too many men coming up before the final sequence.
For Columbus.
Columbus, too many men with 3:24 left to go. The Black Bears are headed back to the Henny Hard Seltzer Power Play. When we come back on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. The Henny Hard Seltzer Power Play is back on the ice, Alex. And with 3:24 left to go, a very important opportunity coming up for the Black Bears.
100%, Brooks. Hey, the Black Bears can kill off a minute, or bring this clock down to a minute 24 left in the game with a two-goal lead. This also puts Columbus in the uncomfortable situation of being a lot of time left without being able to pull their keeper, try to get the equalizer goals up on the board.
Yeah, you know that's got to make Coach Bouchard very unhappy. Crunch time, you're down by two, still within reach if you're Columbus, and you get a bench minor penalty for too many men. Gavin Yates, Tyler Jurich, Mac Lewis, Don Oliveri, along with Tyson Kirkby out on the power play unit for the Black Bears. Oliveri plays it to an open spot, but it'll be backhanded out of the zone. Columbus starts the kill, pushing it down the length of the ice. Going to be served by Jay Krupp on the bench minor. Now Binghamton coming in. Gavin Yates through the middle of the ice as customary. Stick handles around for go, throws on the brakes, back over to Jurich, holding the line, Oliveri, back over to Kirkby. Oliveri loads up a one-timer kick save, Pavlis, rebound by Jurich, is saved by the goaltender. Yates now, back over to Oliveri, a slap shot tipped just wide at the last second. And more cherry picking out at the blue line, and that's what Columbus is gonna have to do as Taylor Joseph plays it all the way back up for Tyler Jurich. Black Bears pull it back into their own zone, knowing that time is their friend as Schultz crosses the line. Partial change right now going on for the Black Bears as a shot put on by Stanko searching for his first right into the chest of the Columbus goaltender.
That's a pickpocket on a pickpocket, Brooks. We got a turducken of pickpockets. Schultz gets his pocket picked. Stanko picks the pocket of the Columbus player, and it gets an incredible scoring opportunity.
First responders night. Post-game jersey auction coming up right after this. Don't forget La Quinta Inn & Suites post-game show as well. Face-off one back by the Black Bears. Schultz over to Smith. Might have been tipped out in front by Stanko. Black Bears jockey for it on the kick plate. Aldworth gets the loose change. Could be a shorthanded opportunity. Wickline coming out in front for Aldworth, who's tied up. Schultz takes a penalty. Probably one you're going to be okay with taking right there, as you don't want Aldworth to get a clean touch right in front of the net with 2 minutes left to go.
However, Brooks, this puts you a man down for the rest of the game, and especially one of your captain, one of your best defenders, an incredibly long stick that's able to break up plays. Schultz just gets him wrapped up on that, and they're going to call that every single time, especially when Aldworth hits the ice.
So that's Binghamton's third penalty of the frame, second against Jake Schultz. 18 minutes time of the penalty. Over 4,200 in attendance tonight. Many have stayed to see this conclusion of the season series between the River Dragons and the Black Bears. It's 4-on-4 as it stands right now. Pavlis staying in his net. King behind the net. Tried to center up for Storja Hand on the back door. Rolled off his stick. Storja Hand trying to create some separation. And King just inside the line. Sasha's one up, tipped wide. Going to be caught up to by Fitzgerald, and the Black Bears can go the other way. Fitzgerald crossing over behind Lopez as the pass was deflected on the way through. Anderson gives chase. Man coming out of the penalty box is Jay Krupp in just a second. Black Bears fall to 1-for-3 on the power play tonight. They have one more left to kill.
You have to think, Brooks, once Columbus gets this into their offensive zone, the keeper's going to be headed to the bench.
Krupp blows a tire right in front of the Black Bears bench. That allows it to be stolen away by Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald content to take some time off instead of dumping it in. Unfortunately, he turns it over, and now Krupp comes back the other way. Loads a cannon up and absorbed by Taylor Joseph.
As Pavlis heads to the bench, Brooks.
58 seconds left to go. And decision time for Coach Bouchard. You call timeout now. 6-on-4 in a two-goal game.
Now, Binghamton does have a little bit of an advantage here, Brooks, because they are on the shorthanded, meaning they can ice the puck and it's not an icing. So even if you miss the empty net, which Columbus just took their timeout right there, even if you miss the empty net opportunity, it's still killing a lot of time for Columbus to go gather the puck, bring it all 200 feet down and collect and get a good opportunity at goal with 58 seconds and needing two goals on top of that.
58 seconds might feel like an eternity for Jake Schultz in the penalty box. As Alex said, the net's empty. Icing is nullified now as the Black Bears are back on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill.
Looks like it's going to be Kirkby, Boylar, Lewis, and Fitzgerald. Some of the faster guys who can also kind of sub in for each other at every position. Lewis and Kirkby will drop into defensive positions when a defender wants to pinch. This is a really good opportunity for the Black Bears to kill off this penalty.
All right, here we go. No time like the present. Faceoff, pushed back by Kirkby. Columbus fighting for it. Back up, and Columbus puts it out of the offensive zone on the power play. 50 seconds left to go. Columbus has to go fast. They need to. They throw it all the way back in. Taylor Joseph on the forehand. Almost turned it over as it was blocked out in front by one of his own teammates. That's always dangerous when you let the goalie take a freebie, but looks like it's going to be dodged out by the Black Bears this time. Now Joseph, a little bit out of position. Kroot fanned on it. Kirkby throws it down the length of the ice, off target by a couple of feet. 20 seconds left to go. Black Bears this close to winning the season series against the River Dragons. Lewis runs into a man at the line. Kirkby in the zone. Steers it on the backhand, off the post. Back out of the zone, 9 seconds left to go. Jay Krupa cherry picking out in front. Joseph comes in and he sent it high. It goes out of play with 2.5 seconds left to go.
An excellent, excellent job. Tyson Kirkby making the smart play instead of the selfish play. Could have taken that a little bit sooner and possibly had a chance to goal. However, he decides, I'm going to hold this puck as long as humanly possible to where I think I can get a decent shot on goal. Held that puck, and ate off so much time off the clock.
Another goalie for
the 2.5 runs off the clock. And the Black Bears defeat the River Dragons by a final score of 5-3. They win the season series over the Columbus River Dragons. They've now extended their home winning streak to 4 games. And maybe this winning mojo is the thing that the Black Bears needed going in to next week.
Yeah, and this really felt like a big game playoff atmosphere, and the Black Bears answered the call every step of the way. They did an excellent job really killing off some really tough opportunities at the end of that game for the Black Bears.
Well, Binghamton gets it done, 5-3. Columbus did score the last goal in the game. Post-game jersey auction to follow suit. 3 points. Unfortunately, it doesn't matter at this point. They're locked into second place. But a win's a win. And the Black Bears extend their win streak at home to 4 games in a row.
But I think this is such an important victory for the Black Bears. This is a young roster with not a ton of playoff experience. You have a few vet guys, of course, like Coachman, like Jurich, like Schultz, who have been there. But this young roster, getting that seasoning and getting them to feel what it's like in a playoff atmosphere and be able to figure out what you need to do to win is huge. Those are invaluable lessons.
Take a timeout. Come back with the La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show right after this on Fox 1430. All right.